All right, everybody, here we are. It's Tuesday, October 1st, 2019, and seriously, we have to talk. We just got hit with a piece of economic news which eclipses the last several rounds of bad economic news by a large margin. Let's talk about that. Before we even move further, we just found out that manufacturing here in the United States just hit a one-decade low. Now, let me ask you, how can we have a booming economy if our manufacturing sector as a whole just hit a one-decade low? Again, it goes back to what I explained to you yesterday. That narrative is the biggest lie since the Kennedy assassination. Our economy here in the United States is an absolute free fall. And just because one individual or more are trying to convince you that our economy is booming and it's the strongest it's ever been, doesn't mean it's true. And all they're going to do is throw out that fake U3 number. You notice they can't do anything else? All you hear about is the fake U3, the unemployment number, the fake U3, and they're using that. They're pinning their hat on it. Everything. All their hopes are pinned on the fake U3 unemployment number. All you gotta do is look around you. A one-decade low with regard to manufacturing here. If we're not making things, we're not growing, we're not exporting anything. This is why the trade deficit here in the United States will continue to get worse, and why China will remain on the winning side of the trade war. It's very simple. It's a very simple concept to understand, although some still won't get it. Now let's talk about how the market reacted. It's kind of interesting. Stock futures were higher across the board. Stocks opened higher, began to gain. I opened a position this morning on the long end of this market, pretty much at the open. I closed it after like 5 minutes. I made a little cash. And I closed that position to do this lovely video. Then all of a sudden again, we could not have gotten a worse round of economic news right here. And this sent the market from a triple digit gain to a triple digit loss. Now let's see how that plays out moving forward. Do I believe this dip is going to get bought up? Yes, I do. Why would I say that? Well, let's look around. The bond market right now, well, at least it was when I started doing this video blog, was selling off in a big way. That means cash is going to look for somewhere to go. Either that cash is going to make its way back into the debt market or it's going to go back into the stock market. Now, we understand the Federal Reserve is firing salvo after salvo after salvo at this market to try to keep it propped up. You think it's going to stop now? No, it's not going to stop now. In fact, it's going to need to get even more extreme. Like I explained to you yesterday, the Federal Reserve is about to go full nuclear. Full nuclear. So let's talk about a few other assets. Let's start off with the basics again. Stocks were higher, now they're selling off. I don't know what they're doing right now as I am doing this video blog. Let's not even worry about it because they're going to get propped up again. We have a sell-off in the debt market. That cash more than likely is going to make its way into the stock market at one point. We have precious metals cashing a little bit of a bid here, although they were under pressure earlier. We have cryptocurrencies catching a bid here. No surprise. Now, here's the other thing that I want to bring to your attention, and it's very big. Crude oil is catching a bid. Do you know why crude oil is catching a bid? Because last night, a rumor was floated out. I told you they're going to either stage a false flag event or they were going to jawbone the market. Well, it looks like they choose to jawbone it last night, the crude oil market at least. The rumor is OPEC is going to cut production. Oh, this is great for crude oil. Boom. Yeah. So, I mean, not anything dramatic, but higher nonetheless. And they will prop it up even further. There should be no doubt in your mind. So let's just put this together like a mosaic so we can understand what we should be doing here to capitalize on this. So stocks were higher out of the gate, fell on absolutely abysmal economic news, the worst in an entire decade. Our economy is in free fall. The next time you hear the president or anyone else explain to you or try to lie to you that our economy is booming, laugh in their face. Even if they can't see you, laugh into the television or whatever device you might be watching it on, because it's a lie. And they're trying to program you or brainwash you into believing that the narrative is real. And the narrative cannot be more fake. Okay, just like this market and everything else connected to it. So we have that. We have a sell-off in the debt market here. More than likely that cash will make its way into the stock market. Will the stock market end positive today? I have no idea. But the six banks that are running the entire show and the Federal Reserve, who has a trading desk, I've proved this to you, will buy the market. There's no doubt about that. They're not just rigging the debt market. You understand that. They're buying stocks. This started in December when Treasury Secretary Mnuchin went to the same six banks that run the Fed and said, buy stocks. He told them to start buying the stock market. The president came out and told everyone to stop buying stocks. Boom! I mean, it's completely rigged. That's what happened in December. We have no resemblance whatsoever of a free market here. And our president did congratulate Communist China on our anniversary. I guess he likes communism. Okay. I think he should have kept his mouth shut with regard to that. But anyway, it seems to be where this world is going, into a socialist, communist, fascist state. But that's a whole other ballgame. We won't even go there. Congratulations on communism! Sorry, I just had to throw that in there. Yeah, that was the president. Kind of baffling to me. But, you know, maybe you think that's a good thing that the president congratulated them on communism. I don't happen to believe communism is the right way to go. I believe if we had a real market, that would be the right way to go. We have a communist market now. We have a managed market. This is why the president, in my view, congratulated communist China. Because again, they have a managed market. They have a managed economy. We have a managed market. We have a managed economy. This is communism in America. I think you get that. But again, there are those who have been programmed who think, oh no, that's not what we have in America. See, they've been dumbed down, and they must follow along like the zombies that they are. Anyway, I'm going to let you all go. Ponder the things I've covered in this video. Very interesting and very sad to see what's happening to America. We are quickly falling off the map with regard to being a world power. And the fact that we're not making things here in America, a one-decade low, a 10-year low, that is epic. And it should say a lot to you when you hear the fake narrative coming out of certain people's mouths. This guy loves you. Please share this video. I'm out of here.